And we're gonna just step in here very briefly because it's really intense in here. So this is cell phone towers.
Look at that. It's unbelievable. And again, I'll show you the meter. Sitting here right in these people's, right outside these people's driveway. Now this is also extremely hard to believe. I've now driven down almost a full block, right next to the telephone pole, down a full block, and check this out. I'm gonna show you the meter reading, and the meter is still up at 2 and 3 volts per meter in the red on the left-hand side at the peak.
Benjamin Rivas has worked on cell phone towers for 14 years.
It physically burned my hand.
The burn is a work injury you can see.
What you see here is what I would call an everyday crime.
Other problems he said caused by the towers aren't as easy to spot.
Depression, and I get headaches from time to time, and mood swings and stuff.
Here's what I consider, in my personal opinion, another crime scene. And I don't think I'm being dramatic saying this. Here's the cell phone tower. I want you to notice where this is located. Literally in the parking lot, right next to these stores. There's human beings working in these stores and eating in these restaurants all day long. And there's a cell phone tower right there. That's hitting 1,000 microwatts per square meter, depending on the pulses that are coming off the tower. I'm across the street, as you can see. I wouldn't even want to guess what the radiation exposure is inside of those stores there. And I have the meter set on average, which you can see here it says RMS, which means microwatts per square meter average power density. This is 800, 900 microwatts per square meter. Goes even higher. Once again, biological effects start at 3.4 to 6 microwatts per square meter average power density.
52-year-old Sanjay Kasliwal is counting the days now. Incurable brain cancer due to radiation from mobile phone towers in his neighborhood has reduced life to little more. His brother has been termed luckier, sent to the US for brain surgery, but both of them know hope fades.
I have written to all possible government offices to find out what sort of control are they doing or what sort of an audit is being done, and it seems everything falls on deaf ears. Nobody is concerned.
Experts say the area the two men live in faces radiation from mobile phone towers equivalent to living in a microwave oven 19 minutes a day.
See, the levels were somewhere between minus 18 to minus 20 dBm also over here. And these radiation levels are very high for prolonged exposure, for almost about 100 times higher than what is, you know, recommended for continuous safe exposure. And there are 2 cancer cases which have been reported in this house. There's even a dog has got cancer.
To broadcast the entire earth, it takes 2 kilowatts, 2 hair dryers. Now, a microwave oven uses 1,000 watts or 1 kilowatt. Here's the damage 1 kilowatt can be done by somebody when they take a magnetron out of a microwave and turn it into a ray gun. This is just a small example of a low-tech weapon running on 1,000 watts. Then you have these things here, these huge towers of death. Now each row in this tower, an array, or a set of dishes or antennas or whatever you want to call them, is connected to a cable with a maximum power output of 300,000 watts, or 300 kilowatts. That's 300 microwave ovens. We base that conservative estimate based on the gauge of the cabling that's running up to one of these arrays. They're estimated at 300,000 watts per cable. Those aren't fiber optic cables running up to those arrays. It's a thick copper gauge transmission line quality cable running up those towers. Now, if there's 10 cables, that's like 3 megawatts of power. And these cables are out there to output power to the magnetron, not for data transfer. That's an important point. These cell phone towers are weaponized. There's no other reason to have this much power running up the cables. It isn't for data transfer. Now, FCC regulations limit normal transmission per array to about 400 watts. To put that into perspective, 1 watt from your phone can go 25 miles to the nearest tower. A 1,000-watt magnetron on a stick can blow shit up. And these towers have a 300-kilowatt power line running up to each rectenna. And who knows, there could be an amplifier at the top of these towers that steps up the power even more. The point is here, ladies and gentlemen, is that these companies, like Lucent and Google, could turn up the juice at any time and nuke a town. They could nuke the entire country without any warning, without anybody being able to protect themselves. They could cook them like a boiling frog in the middle of the night. This infrastructure is not only in place, it's built up with multiple levels of redundancy. Every big city has thousands of these death towers. And all that needs to happen is for an AI from Google or whoever to come in and nuke everybody at once and take over. Who out there remembers that movie Terminator? Well, Google doesn't have to send a Terminator to every door or launch a nuclear strike. It can just turn on these cell phone towers to maximum and cook everybody within the city limits within an hour. And then just send in the Terminators to mop up the countryside.